Ice creams, mate. Strawberry sauce for you.
Oh, as requested. There we go. Love that. Love that.
Oh. So, other than the ice creams, why are we here today?
Well, the ice creams are the main reason, obviously, as a given. But I thought it'd be cool to have a little bit of a challenge where we... well, let me explain that. So we've got a challenge each. First challenge is that one of us only has 50 shots in the whole day. We can walk wherever we want. We can walk around the town. We can go on the pier.
So roughly the equivalent to two rolls of film.
Exactly, yeah. And then the other challenge is that the other person will have as many shots as they want. So they can take 1,000 shots if they want, but they are confined to 50 steps. How does that sound to you?
Yeah. They're both going to be a bit of a challenge, aren't they?
Yeah.
I'll go for the 50 yards.
I thought you'd go for the other one.
Oh, and I'll let you take the 50 shots.
Okay.
Yeah?
50 steps, not 50 yards. So you've, okay. so you've only got 50 individual steps.
See, I'm already trying to make it larger, aren't I?
Yeah. And we'll, should we say 2 hours? 2 hour limit?
2 hours. What, meet back here?
Yeah.
And see how we get it on, yeah?
So may the best man win. Yep.
Good luck. See you later, man.
Okay. Right, well, Matt has headed off towards the pier, and I think that's probably a good move. That's what I would do as well, because that seems to be sort of where all the action is. This end of the sort of the beach is a little bit quieter. But I've hung around here because this is a really nice little stretch of kind of pavement right next to the beach, and some quite interesting characters kind of walking along. So like loads of people with dogs and like older people and stuff. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hang out for someone to come along. I'm going to use a really wide angle lens. This is a 17 to 40. I'm going to use it at 17. And I've got this nice blue sky and a white wall. And I'm just going to shoot like a side on shot of them walking past. So quite a minimal image. And I just need to wait for the right person, because I'm really tight on shots. So I need to make sure I don't waste any.
Now, deciding which spot to begin in has really been a challenge, to be honest. There's a lot of stuff going on here, but it's all spread out down the promenade. It all goes on for miles, and that's going to be the advantage that Tim's going to have, is that he's going to be able to walk around and find those great subjects. And, you know, okay, he's limited in how many shots he can take, but as long as he nails those images, you know, he's not going to have a problem. I've really been restricted, and 50 yards is not as far as you think. I've just been counting, and I think it's roughly just up the stairs by the pier there. Now, I've chose this spot because there's a few interesting things going on around here. We've got the deck chairs behind me here, the deck chair hire. Maybe I can take some classic seascape images here. There's some donkeys further back. Maybe I can take a couple of portraits of them. And there's a few things going on and a few people milling around. So, you know, hopefully there'll be some images there. But this, and deciding on a spot, has really been a challenge. So, currently I feel like Tim chose the better option. All right, well, I'm going to start taking some shots, so wish me luck. Now, as soon as I press my shutter, my 50 steps are going to start. So I'm just going to take a bit of time here to frame up and really get my first image in place before I press that shutter down. Okay, well, that's my first shot. I guess this is the start of my 50 steps.
Well, I've just been to the sweet shop on the pier, and I've bought myself a 50p stick of rock for a little photo idea that I've got. So the idea is that the rock has Great Yarmouth written in the middle, so I've kind of snapped it off and eaten the other half. And I'm going to hold it out at arm's length, and I'm going to focus on the Great Yarmouth, and I'm going to use a 24 to 70 lens with an f2.8 maximum aperture, and I'm going to shoot at f2.8. That's going to give me a really shallow depth of field, so that the Great Yarmouth is in focus, but the background, the sun and the sea and the sand in the background, which is the way I'm facing, will be all out of focus. So that's going to help draw attention to the end of that rock. So let's give this a go. So f2.8. Okay, nice fast shutter speed. Let's have a go. I'm just going to zoom in a bit here. Go to about 50 mil. Really like that. That works.
Okay, so on this challenge, as far as I'm concerned, everything is a potential subject. You know, anything that might work, I'm going to give it a bash. And you might see behind me there's three benches, and different people are coming along and sitting on them and carrying on with their day and having some fun. So what I think I might do is try and get some portraits of them. Now, I'm going to have to go quite wide because I'm kind of stuck with this lens here. I haven't got anything that's really going to zoom in. But I think, yeah, maybe I'll try and build up a bit of a series of portrait images, and that's what I'll do.
Well, I felt like I was doing really, really well with this challenge. Started to get a few really good shots, and I was getting into kind of like, you know, not just getting my camera out and shooting loads of stuff, but actually thinking through shots before I pressed the shutter. And then it all kind of suddenly went wrong. I saw this dog on the beach, and he was like goofing around in the water, and he was running along, and I got my long lens out. And then like I started shooting it, and I was just like, and I'd used up like 20 shots, and they're all out of focus. They're all blurred. I totally blew it. So I've only got a few shots left in the tank now. What I'm going to do is right here on the... So there's a little wooden walkway that sort of goes down the beach to the sea. And it's quite nice, but earlier on it was like packed full of people, so it wasn't really a goer. But now it's empty. It's sort of the end of the day. There's no one here. So I'm going to head off down there now.
35, 36, 37.
Oh, moving subjects. Look, you got to keep your eyes open here.
Okay, so this is about the right position, I think. And if I get my camera really, really low, I can get sort of the edges of the walkway just kind of coming out of the bottom two corners of the frame, if I zoom fully out, which looks pretty nice. So there's those nice leading lines that just kind of draw the eye into the shot. And I'm also going to use, for this shot, a circular polarizer. This one's a nice thin coking one. And just screws onto the end of the lens, and then you turn the end piece of glass, and it's going to give me nice deep blue skies, but not affect the clouds. So what I need to do is kind of just twist the end piece until I feel that the sky is about right, which is about there. And then I'm using the widest aperture I've got, which is f4. And I'm just going to focus on a really close bit of, the closest I can focus there. Bit of stone and sand there, okay, and then recommit, and then I'm gonna take the shot. And that is actually pretty nice, really pleased with that.
Okay, so you can't always wait for a shot, sometimes you've got to go back to that classic seaside fallback option and just build a stone tower. That's exactly what I've done here. I'm gonna base a shot all around composition, maybe put the stones on one of the rule of third lines, and maybe go quite wide still, and still show that I'm here at the beach, I'm at the seaside, but use a wide aperture so that I can really focus attention onto my stone tower, and I think that's going to be my next shot.
Matty boy.
Hey man, how'd you get on?
How's it going? Good.
Yeah, not bad, bud.
Did you forget the sun cream or something? Looking a bit pink.
It's been a sunny day.
Yeah.
It has been a sunny day.
My arms have gone a bit as well.
So, 50 shots, any worth keeping?
I think so. I mean, it was a difficult exercise, no doubt about it, you know.
Yeah.
So it was really hard going, but feeling a bit tired now. I've walked about 5 miles, I reckon, whereas
yeah.
You've only walked about 30 metres, haven't you, or something like that?
Probably, something like that. Not very far at all.
Yeah. So, how did you find it?
Yeah, it was a challenge. I mean, I tried to pick a spot that I thought there was going to be some great, great potential images,
yeah.
And I got a couple of shots. I kind of felt like I exhausted my potential subjects after a while. But then, you know, with people walking into the shots and stuff like that, you know,
the environment
okay.
does change,
it does,
doesn't it?
It does yeah. change, and I think, you know, maybe that's what it did for me. You know, I started to think about things a little bit more and
yeah.
find those angles and really work with the subjects as opposed to just going for that instant shot every time, that first angle that you see.
And
you
it's
know?
Amazing what you can find, isn't it? Like some little things that you perhaps wouldn't spot normally when you actually look for them, you know, pictures
definitely.
Are there.
If you look hard enough and, you know, really work with it, then there are shots everywhere.
Yeah.
And, you know.
But hats off to you for actually, you know, sticking to the rules.
I'll be checking your file numbers as well, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Hopefully
yeah,
you were sticking to the rules as
I did,
well.
Yeah, I stuck to 50, although I saw this dog on the beach and, like,
yeah.
it was, I just, like, got carried away and I really let myself down. I shot, like, 20 shots of it, like, really. Just wasted 20 shots.
Let's hope there was one good one.
No, they weren't. They're all blurred. Anyway, if you feel you've been rushing through locations and not really spending time, like really crafting your images, then maybe it's time to sort of change the way that you shoot. why not try one of these two challenges to really help hone your photographic ability? From Great Yarmouth, see you next time.
Right, should we get the okay?
Yeah, go on.
I'll win you a teddy.
Brilliant.
Okay.
I'll get my bag.